Hello, dear student. Good afternoon. So our today's lecture is on the topic types of mouth parts of insect. So in the last lecture, we learned that a detail about this head and different head position. Okay. So today and discuss on the types of mouth parts. Okay. So on the types of mouth parts that having two main functional group, and these two main functional group are that commonly mandibulate and the hostulate. This mandibulate and hostulate are having the different types of mouth parts were included. This mandibulate type is called that is those insect have to chew the feed, isn't it? That having chewing and biting type of mouth parts. Okay, so and those are the feeds on the liquid feeders, and here these are the solid feeder insect. So here in this mandibulate, the insect are namely dragonfly, damselfly, that which comes under in order Odonata, termites, that in the Isoptera order, adult green lacewing, that in the Neuroptera, some beetles that responsible that to feeding, and it comes under in Coleoptera, some having the ants, Hymenoptera, cockroaches, that is the Blattaria, grasshopper, crickets, and catids are orthopteran insect, and the most of the lepidopteran insect that having the immature stage, that's commonly known as the caterpillars and larva. These all insect have the chewing and biting type of mouth parts, somewhere chewing and lapping type of mouth parts. Okay, so this all that comes under in mandibulate, and those are the liquid feeder insect that primarily use for sucking the liquid and can be broken down inside the plant tissue with the help of two groups like stylate and without stylate. So these are comes under in liquid feeder, that's commonly that rasping and sucking, piercing and sucking. Okay, that are the sponging, siphoning, that all are hostulate type of mouth parts. Okay, so now see which are these major that types of mouth parts. Actually, the many insects that feed on plant, even that in animal, in plant that cause damage by defoliation, or even also some are the suckers that feed by the sucking. Okay, so sap. Even in animal and human also that to suck the blood by this using the different stylate were used to suck the blood and different sap from the plant. Okay, so the nature of injury that caused that mostly depends on the different types of mouth parts that having or that possessed by the insect, and these different types of mouth part they are the modified in different ways, like chewing and biting type of mouth parts, example cockroach and grasshopper. Okay, even piercing and sucking type of mouth parts, different plant bugs, mosquito, aphid, mealybugs, even also red cotton bug, jacid, that having the piercing and sucking. Rasping and sucking, they having the only one example, that trips. Sponging or lapping, we can say that in case of the housefly, and chewing and lapping honeybees, siphoning butterflies and different moths, mask type that naiad of dragonfly, that immature stage of this dragonfly or damselfly, it's a naiad. And lastly, degenerate type of mouth parts that mostly in dipteran maggots, that is immature stage of the different housefly, those having the true flies. These are the maggots that having the degenerate type of mouth part. So student, these are the all 7 to 8 types of mouth parts that comes under in different type of insect. Okay, so let's see the first one that called as that figure. We can see here the figure. This is the figure of chewing and biting type of mouth part. This is the figure chewing and biting type of mouth part that having labrum, two mandibles, hypopharynx, that is tongue, maxilla, one pair of maxilla, and labium. This is overall, these parts comes under in chewing and biting type mouth part. Same in case of hemipteran, that is the piercing and sucking, that having the forced dilate here. Okay, so these are the comes under him, piercing and sucking. In case of the moth and butterfly, those are the comes under in the long proboscis, that oil like proboscis, that known as siphoning type of mouth parts. Okay, so these are figure I'm showing you. This is the figure of piercing and sucking. This is the figure of chewing and lapping, that having the long flabellum, spoon shaped flabellum, where I'm marking or that to showing you on slide. This is the long flabellum proboscis, that is chewing and lapping type of mouth parts in honeybees. Okay. Even this is also the siphoning. This is the sponging, that having the sponge like organ, that labella, and this is a whole portion of this housefly mouth part, that are the sponging type of mouth parts in case of housefly. Now student, our main first mouth parts are chewing and biting type of mouth parts. These are the parts that I'm that highlighted on the slide. Okay, so this is the first one, labrum to mandible to maxillae and hypopharynx, and these are the labium. This is on the mandible. Okay, this chewing and biting type of mouth parts is the basic and most primitive type of mouth parts, and generally that present in the insect, the cockroach, grasshopper, beetles, even the immature stage of lepidopteran insect, that are the larvae or caterpillar. So let's see the one by one, this whole the parts of chewing and biting type of mouth parts. Actually, these are the liquid, these are the not liquid feeders, these are the solid food, those are ingested, the pest, okay, or that insect, they having the chewing and biting type mouth parts, and these are the suited for solid food chewing type. Okay, so the mouth parts consist of labrum, that is called as the upper lip. This is the upper lip, that is a labrum. So we can detail see in this labrum, it is a single unpaired sclerite. It is also sclerite, we learned in different sclerite of head capsule. So where I am mentioned there the sclerite, okay, which is movable. It is a movable, and which is attached to the lower end of clypeus. Here that lower end, that broad plate like structure here, that of clypeus, they are attached with the help of or along with the clypeolabral suture. So there is the one suture that responsible or that having the participate to connect or to join with the labrum and clypeus. Okay, so it forms preoral cavity, it forms a preoral cavity, or we can say it is a roof of preoral cavity. Okay, and just overlying the mandibles. Okay, there is a notch, okay, is a middle one, and which helps to hold the food material while feeding. Here one notch is where present, okay, it is in the middle portion inside. So this notch is helpful to hold the food material during feeding. Labrum is generally capable that for the slide forward and backward like position that move, and sometimes a little up and down movement done by this labrum. Why? Because of which gets or to use the help to pull up the food into the preoral cavity. That's why this is the labrum is very important. Okay, so generally this notch way I said, this is generally provided in the grasshopper to hold the lip blade. Even also that too during the feeding time or feeding time of different food. So that time this labrum is helpful. Okay, so now, so second part of chewing and biting type is a mandibles. It is a one paired mandibles that on this chewing and biting type. So this one paired mandibles are highly sclerotized part of insect, and which are two in number, and also it is known as the first pair of jaw. Why it is called first pair? Because it is on the upper position, not in lower, that because lower lower jaw is a maxillary, but upper jaw is a mandible, and they are the highly sclerotized and which is are articulated to the head by two organ or two parts were located that inside the hair capsule, that is called as a gingival mesh and condyle. This is the two part where articulation occur inside the mandible, and each mandible are that highly chitinized solid and which having the serrate in position here, that are the serrate. Why it is serrate? That is called as a tooth. These are the tooth, or why it is used for this, that having the serrated inner margin and that and molar region, which is used for cutting. This serrated and tooth like, why? For the cutting and grinding the solid food material. This इथे जे दिसतंय आपल्याला हे पूर्ण हे दातळी सारखं इनर मार्जिन अँड लोअर मार्जिन. ओके, सो दिस मँडिबल दॅट हॅव्हिंग दॅट व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट फॉर द क्रशिंग सॉलिड फूड मटेरियल कटिंग. दिस व्हाय? बिकॉज इनर मार्जिन आर टूथ अँड डिस्टल इन्सिजर टीथ दॅट इज यूज फॉर अँड मोस्टली मोलर टीथ फॉर द क्रशिंग. सो दिस इज हॅव्हिंग द इम्पॉर्टंट वन. अँड ईच जॉ ऑर ईच मँडिबल दॅट मूव्स हॉरिझॉन्टली. Why? Because here that presence of that very much important powerful muscles, and this powerful muscle that are outer is the abductor. It abductor muscle astat ya sarke, and here that inner muscle that is called as a adductor muscle. Abductor, adductor. So this is two are the muscle, outer and inner, that for the moving this horizontally by using two different powerful muscle by that called as abductor and adductor. So this is overall the mandible that useful for the cutting and crushing and purpose in solid food particles. So these are the very helpful. Okay, so now this mandibles that having the left mandible overlap with the right. Okay, so this is overall this description or information regarding this mandible. Now this let's see in the detail about the insect maxilla. This is whole figure of insect maxilla, and this maxilla having the different parts, cardo, its stipes, and its a pulpifer here, and this is the maxillary pulp, and here the two lobe, that is a lacinia and the gallia. Okay, and the subgallia also here. Okay, so this maxillae are in the two in number generally here also I am showing you, sorry, two in number. This is the first one and this is the next one. This is the two in number. Now also it is known as a second pair of jaw. It is a second pair of jaw, that is the maxillae, and each maxillae is made up of different sclerite and appendages, that is sclerite or appendages or parts consist of or composed by cardo, stipe, pulpifer, maxillary pulp, lacinia, gallia and subgallia. So what is mean by cardo? Cardo is a triangular basal part or basal sclerite to the head, that is a cardo, and which is attached to the head at the lower side of post jejuna, where that on the cheek region of insect head capsule, that on the posteriorly this post jejuna here this cardo attached, that is a cardo. Now what is stipes? Stipes is a quadrangular, it is a quadrangular part of insect maxilla. Okay, so this is cardo, sorry, this stipes, and which is it is also the forming the body of maxilla, and which is articulated within a like a cardo, that is just situated above the cardo, and which laterally it bears a sclerite, which is laterally bears a sclerite known as pulpifer here. This is the pulpifer. Okay, and this which is on five segmented, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, a past segment je banlela jo part hai, that is pulpifer. Okay, so that here I am that showing you. Let's see, this is one pulpifer, the lateral part of this tapes. Okay, so now what is this pulpifer that having again here 5 segmented that presence of this pulpifer, and there is called as maxillary pulp, and which is are the lateral side on that step. Okay, this pulp maxillary pulp which is situated on step. Okay, now this pulpifer, it is a lateral sclerae, and maxillary pulp which is a sensory appendages, and which is articulated to these types. Okay, and this is types with the pulpifer. It is 1 to 5 segmented of this maxillary pulp. And now let's see in the galea. Okay, what is mean by galea? Galea is the distally the maxilla, distally that maxilla present, or which is the outer lobe which hoods or that located on inner side on that lacinia. Okay, and which having this galea is it is at the articulated at outerly outer articulating at the end on this type, at the end on this is the type, this part, and which is articulated that on this steps. It is a at the end of steps, at the end of steep is galea, and inner that is known as a lacinia. Okay, and the galea which is 2 segmented, which is the 2 segmented galea, and which is overlaps to the lacinia, which is overlap with to the lacinia like a hood, as a hood that act as a inside this lacinia, and this lacinia, this galea which is 2 segmented and overlap to the lacinia, that is galea. Lacinia, it is a outer lobe, it is a outer lobe and possessing spiny margin. Here that spiny margin, इथे मी तुम्हाला दाखवतोय, दिस इज द स्पाइनी मार्जिन ऑफ लॅसिनिया. ओके, सो दॅट प्रेझेंट इन साइड दॅट स्टाइप. ओके, अँड विच इज इनर लोब अँड विच इज आर्टिक्युलेटिंग विद इन दॅट डिस्टल मार्जिन ऑन स्टिप्स, वेअर ऑन स्टिप. ओके, इट इज अ ब्लेड लाईक, कसं असतं ते ब्लेड लाईक असतं, अँड विच इज कॉमनली स्पाइन ऑर टूथ. Okay, on its inner margin. Why? It gives the helps to the mandible during the holding the food material or while feeding the food material, this lacinia is helpful. Okay, so in case of the coleopterous larvae, that galea and lacinia are found together. जर आपण बघितलं काय बिटलच्या लार्वी मध्ये हे लॅसिनिया आणि हे गॅलिया आर द फूड टुगेदर ऑर दॅट टू found together and to form a single lobe. हे दोन्ही लोब कसे असतात, सिंगल लोब सारखे दिसतात, आणि त्यामध्ये त्याला म्हणतात माला. When this lacinia and galea are put together, where in beetle larvae, beetle caterpillar, so where this put together or fused together called as a mala. So that is the insect maxillary. So the hypopharynx, hypopharynx means what? It is a that is a tongue which is found behind the mouth, and here that salivary gland ducts were open or at its base. But in most of the diptera, that in the house fly, in hemiptera, sucking pest, sucking insect, it has become highly modified that to convert into the different canal and other thing. So where this hypopharynx, so it is a tongue like prolongation of the floor of mouth cavity, tongue like a floor of mouth cavity where the salivary gland duct opens at its base. Okay, and the function of hypopharynx or tongue is to mix the saliva with the food material, that where the important. Okay, it is more or less covered with the hairs. Okay, generally the salivary gland duct opens through the hypopharynx. Okay, so this is overall this hypopharynx. Now what is labium? Labium means what? It is also called as second maxillary, second maxillary, and it is attached with the lower end, okay, lower end or the neck, and it encloses mouth cavity, which is encloses mouth cavity from below, and which is consist of the different sclerite like submentum, mentum and prementum, submentum, mentum and prementum. Okay, so this is overall that some parts were inside, So that we can say it is divided into different three parts. Anteriorly, that is a prementum, middle mentum, and posteriorly, that is a submentum. Prementum, it's important. Why? It bears a three segmented labial part here, one, then two, and then three. It is a three segmented labial pulp that on this anteriorly on that prementum, and which is where the bone on this scleroid of palpiger, actually here that boning or arising of this palpiger, isn't it? On maxillary there is the palpifer, but in case of the labium I'm talking about the palpiger. Okay, on the anterior margin it bears a two pairs of some two lobes, that is a glossa on this inner here, glossa, that is the inner lobe, and paraglossa, which is the outer lobe. This is one paraglossa. Okay, so this glossa and paraglossa, when fused to form a median lobe, when this glossa and paraglossa fused to form median lobe, which is called as ligula, isn't it? This is called as ligula, and in general the function of labium is to close the mouth cavity ventrally, and which is also helps to the maxilla during the process of feeding. So this is overall this labium of this chewing and biting type of mouth parts. So student, this is all of these parts of chewing and biting type of mouth parts. So thank you. This is overall our today's lecture. Thank you very much.